Hey Poodles, Richard Ryder here with This Week on Out TV. Well, on Monday's brand new episode of Men's Fashion Insider, we check out this season's looks from Marc Jacobs, Trissardi, and Strauss in black and white.
Marc Jacobs, that line is conceptual, it's Marc's aesthetic, it's Marc's soul. This is Marc having fun, and there's just a sense of delight in how he sees youth. I think he has a gift in understanding and understanding how young people see themselves and how they want to be seen.
Also on Monday, we've got another brand new episode of The Face of Furry Creek. This week, Chad and Guy decide to rate the Creek's finest women.
This week, we'll start them off with an easy one, blogging. We want to put our finalists' computer and writing skills to the test.
Doing a blog about meth addiction and former female inmate?
No, man, what do we love most about Furry Creek?
Besides snowboarding? I guess, girl?
Yeah, man, chicks!
We received not one, but two blog posts about the most bang-worthy of Furry Creek's female residents.
And finishing off Monday, it's another brand new episode of Boys Town. This week, Jake gets creeped out, Rick fantasizes about a client, and Michael gives TJ relationship advice.
Oh, hi, I'm Jake. I'm a buddy of his visiting from Portland.
Hey, well, come on in.
You know, Ryan, he's recording at my studio. You know, I give music lessons too, if you're interested. I'm sure that I could work something out with you as well.
You're at the...
Patrick, what are you doing here?
I thought I would drop by so we could discuss our arrangement.
What the hell just happened here?
On Tuesday, we've got another brand new episode of Country Dreams. This week, we visit northern Spain, known for its endless meadows, grazing cattle, and impressive rock formations jutting out of the Blue Bay of Biscay. God, if I had a nickel for every time somebody asked me to look at their rock formation.
El viñedo. Es la apuesta del señor de Rubianes, último señor de Rubianes, para conseguir consolidar una actividad que pueda tener sinergias con lo que ya existente, que viene de los ancestros, y que pueda continuar y estar seguir una, siendo una finca como la que es hoy.
On Wednesday's brand new episode of In the Kitchen, you gotta brace yourself because sexy Stefano gets up close and personal with nuts. Now calm down, it's pistachios, walnuts, things like that. I know I'm disappointed too.
Nuts are really versatile. They add a nice crunch to so many recipes. So first up is the pistachio. I'm making fusilli with tomatoes and pistachios, an easy pasta dish for any night of the week. Then the hazelnut. Mmm. But today I'm making grilled lamb chops with hazelnut tapenade. Great for dinner parties. Yes. And finally the walnut. My walnut crusted sole with a Swiss chard and walnut sauté is a nutty double shot. So are we ready to get cooking?
Yeah. We're watching Gaby. It's the story of a straight girl and a gay guy who decide to fulfill a childhood promise to have a baby together. The old-fashioned way.
How's this for new? Jen asked me to have a baby with her.
That is so Brooklyn.
Should I take my bra off?
Oh, God, no.
You're not pregnant though, right?
Why are you asking me? We were safe.
You were telling me not to stop. I thought you felt it break and didn't care.
I care!
Is something wrong?
No, no. Just been working a lot. I'm really tired.
He said he won't come home until you aren't here anymore.
Which brings us to Sunday, and in honor of Father's Day, we're watching the remake of The Birdcage, starring Gene Hackman, Robin Williams, Nathan Lane, and Diane Wiest, because you don't have to dress like a father to be one.
We're getting married. This is my mother.
What? It's out of the question. You can't get married, not even 18.
Who is this boy, Barbie?